What's going on, everyone? I'm Thomas Sotomayor. I want to do a quick blog because I'm getting ready for the show tonight. But I just had a discussion with a few black women on Facebook, and it's kind of bothering me because it shows to me how just utterly ridiculous black women are, how self-absorbed they are, and how no matter what they do, they feel like they can come out smelling like a rose at the end. Let me explain. I put up a post and it said, Thomasism. There's nothing classy or sexy about a woman with a chest tattoo. It only shows how trashy, ratchet, and manly you are. You'd assume people without chest tattoos would say amen. But you wouldn't assume that people who have chest tattoos would come and take up for it. Here's an example. Women, have you ever posted about deadbeat dads and said, nigga that don't take care of his kids is blah, blah, blah. And saw a bunch of men come on the page and explained why they don't take care of their kids. Tell you how wrong you were. Have you ever put up a post and said, men that cheat on their girls ain't shit. And had a bunch of men come on your post who cheat on their girls and say, you don't understand, you just hating. But black women do this all the time. No matter what it is you say in your own zone, if they don't like it because they fit it, which is usually the reason they don't like it, they will come to argue with you. Now, this woman went on to say this, and I quote, and this shows you the stupidity of black women. Well, the first thing she put was, wow, I have one and I'm very much a lady, and don't you forget it. Then she thumbs up her own post, the only one to thumbs up her post. So if you notice, there's a trend that black women thumbs up their own shit. They love their own shit. They are their own biggest cheerleaders. That's why when they argue and they clap, because they need an audience to hype them up. When they saying stuff, they clapping. They're their own best defender, their own biggest supporter. When you thumbs up in your own post on Facebook, you suck. Anyway, she went on to say, Tommy, I never said it wasn't a stupid decision, but it doesn't mean I'm not a lady and can also define myself as a lady just fine. Thank you very much. And not just because I'm a beautiful and black woman. That's just one reason. Well, here was my reply. That's your opinion of you, that you're beautiful. Every black woman thinks that they are a lady and that they're a beautiful black woman. I don't care to wait on a woman to go through bullshit to come out smelling like a rose. It's not right. Only black women can shake off everything that they've ever done and still be ladies. Fuck that. You have that mark on you from your unladylike days. White women accept it. Black women, they don't. White women get a tramp stamp and they call it a tramp stamp. The white men call that thing on their back a tramp stamp. And white women don't sit around arguing it. I'm not a tramp. I'm not a tramp. Their men call it a tramp stamp. They agree with it because the men are the ones who are back there looking at it. So their opinion should matter a little bit. Black women get beast stamps, not tramp stamp, beast stamp. And then they want to be called a lady. Now you ask me, what is a beast stamp? Only a beast would get a tattoo on her chest. Only a woman who thinks she's a man would get a tattoo on her chest. You're a beast. You're not even a tramp, because at least a tramp gets a tattoo across their back. It's something cutesy, and you see it when you're hitting it from the back. It's a tramp stamp. What the fuck am I doing with this big tattoo on your chest? What am I doing when I'm on top of you? What am I doing? Please, seriously, answer for me. But they don't have an answer for their beast stamp, because that's what it is. You need to start calling it that. Fellas, when you see any woman with a tattoo on her chest, it is a beast stamp. Remind her of it. She's a beast. It's what you do to a beast. Anyway, I don't understand. And I continued to explain to her. I said, that's like a redneck running around with a Confederate flag and a Klan outfit and still trying to tell you that he's not racist. See, black women, if you want to be treated like a lady, get the tramp stamp off you. But black women don't want you to hold their past against them, even if their past is in front of you. I understand if you used to be a hoe in college and I wasn't in college with you. Then of course I can't judge you on something I don't see and don't know. That makes sense. I don't believe that any woman should be held, or man or anybody else should be held to what they did in the past if they're not putting it in your face now. But the problem is the things that black women do, they're putting in your face now. They have four kids by four different men, but still tell you you can't call them a hoe. But you're on a date with them and you see these four little niggas by four different niggas. Why would I refer to you as a lady? You didn't clean yourself up. You just stopped doing the whore shit because you can't do it anymore. I don't understand why is it that when black women go do all the dirtiest stuff in the world, they still have that dirt on them. They can't wash it off. You see it. Why not do the dirt you can wash off? Lauryn Hill didn't do the dirt she could wash off. That dirt's with her for the rest of her life. There's some dirt you can't wash off, and you can't look have people look at you. If you have herpes, you have herpes. You have it for the rest of your life. You can't expect people to look at you like you don't have it when they see it with you every day. Now, some people will accept it. Some people won't. But you can't make people look at you as a clean individual when you're not. But that's what women expect men to do. That's what black women expect black men to do. You have to somehow vow. That's why the only ones that try to talk to white boys are the ones that don't have all them tattoos, that don't have all them kids. Notice every time a black girl can get with a white man, she don't have all them kids. Because she has to come at him with something better than she has to come at us with. They look at us as trash. That's why they don't mind coming at us with five kids by five different men, still telling you, you have to treat this woman like a lady. You got to take this woman out on dates. That's why they don't mind having B stamps on them and still telling you that they ladies. Go get a white man with a tattoo on your chest. Can't do it, can you? Go get a white man with three kids by three deadbeat dads. Can't do it, can you? Why not? You wouldn't even approach a white man like that because he wouldn't fuck with you. They have a standard. We don't. Their standards of women are conveyed by the men. Black people's standards of women are conveyed by the women. That didn't make any sense. You don't set your own damn price. The market does. But I don't understand why these women, and you can go on my fan page and look. The women were arguing something that I thought myself, which was a chest tattoo on a woman is trashy and nasty. Why would anybody disagree with that? White women with chest tattoos came and said, that is pretty true. That's why we hang out with bikers, because we know we ain't supposed to be running around with lawyers and chest tattoos. That don't make sense. Black women literally think they can do whatever they want to do and still marry a president. Do whatever they want to do and still be looked at as any other woman. Just as classy. Even though when she wears a spaghetti strap dress to the company function, she got her ex-boyfriend name on there that she had to re-tattoo over and make it look like something else. Stop arguing stupid shit, black women, please. You got a chest tattoo? That's trashy. No one else sees it any other way. Except you. Stop having all these kids and then expecting somebody to say, well, I'm still going to view you like a woman with no kid. It's not true. Stop being 40, now going to church and saying that you're just like any other woman. You're not a new virgin. You're just a bitch that pussy done got too old and got tired of getting fucked. That's it. Ah, that's my rant. Let me get ready for the show. All right, I'm out.